स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक. एंड ऑन दिस इवनिंग वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व इन टेक्स्ट न्यूमेरिकल्स. ओके, ऑन पेज नंबर 109 एंड 110 ऑफ योर बुक एंड चैप्टर नंबर इज 8. ओके, विच इज मोशन. एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व न्यूमेरिकल्स फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 ऑन दिस पेज नंबर, गिवन पेज नंबर 109 एंड 110. ओके, the numericals are very simple and based on equation of motions. Okay, there are three equations of motion that I have already told you, and I have already uploaded the video in which I have derived all three equations of motion. Okay, you can watch that. Okay, for my help I have written all the questions on this paper and you can see in your NCERT textbook. Okay, for your help. Okay, now let's see question number 1. And what is given in this question number 1? I am reading from this paper and you can see in your book. The question number 1 on page number 9 is, a bus is starting from rest. Okay, so whenever a bus or any vehicle is starting from rest, as it will not be moving when it is starting, that's why we will take its initial velocity to be 0. Okay, so initial velocity to be 0 as it is starting from rest. So we may write in the bracket, but it is not really required, but for make you understand I am just writing as bus is starting from rest, as bus is starting from rest. Okay, okay, now next thing is, starting from rest moves with uniform acceleration of 0.1 meter. So acceleration is given 0.1 meter per second square. Okay, now what, for 2 minutes time is given. Okay, t is equals to 2 minutes time is given. Just we have to convert the time whenever it is given in minutes or hours, because whenever we will use equations of motion then we will use SI units. Okay, so converting this time into seconds, 2 into 60. In 1 minute there are 60 seconds, so in 2 minutes 2 multiply by 60 seconds and it will be 120 seconds really. Okay, this is the time. Okay, now what, in part number A, find the speed acquired. Now in part number A we have to find how much speed it will acquire, so I have write that V. Okay, V for final velocity. Final velocity is to be asked. So let's say question is part number A. To find V, it means final speed. Which equation can be used whenever these information are given? Then we may use equation number, equation motion first. Okay, to find V, we have first equation of motion. Okay, first equation of motion. First equation of motion is V equals to U plus AT. Okay, or we may put the value V we have to find, and U is 0 plus A is 0.1 into T is 120 seconds. So multiplying this we get 12.0 meter per second. Okay, this will be the velocity acquired by the bus. Okay, this will be the answer of first part. Now come to part number 2. Okay, its part number 2 is, it has been asked in other part, the distance traveled. Now distance traveled is to be asked. Okay, and additionally time is given and distance is asked. Then we may use equation number 2. Okay, so we will write by equation second. Okay, equation second, what second equation used to be, s is equals to ut plus 1 by 2 at square. Okay, this used to be second equation of motion. So putting the value, s equals to u is 0 into 120 plus 1 by 2, a ki value kitni hai, acceleration is 0.1 into t ki value 120 ka square. Okay, और s is equals to, ये पूरा 0 हो जाएगा ये पूरी वैल्यू, प्लस 1 by 2 इंटू 0.1 इंटू 120 का स्क्वायर, मतलब 120 मल्टीप्लाई 120, 2 से ये 60 टाइम्स हो जाएगा, 60 टाइम्स ये जो है डिवाइड हो जाएगा और s इज इक्वल्स टू नाउ इट विल बी 0.1 इनटू 60 मल्टीप्लाई 120 इट विल बी 0.1 मल्टीप्लाई 60 कितना होगा 6.0 ओके मल्टीप्लाई 120 और इट विल बी s इज इक्वल्स टू इट विल बी 720 मीटर्स ओके Then it means in final answer we may write the speed acquired by the bus will be 12 meter per second and distance covered will be 720. Okay, the bus will acquire speed 12 meter per second and cover a distance of and cover a distance of 720 meters. Okay, this is how numerical number 1 will be solved. It is very easy. Okay, now let's do next question. Okay, fine. Next question is question number numerical number 2. I hope ki you aapne jo isko note kar liya hoga. So main क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 कर रहा हूं और इसे इरेज कर देता हूं ओके सो क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 व्हाट इज गिवन क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 इज अ ट्रेन इज ट्रेवलिंग एट अ स्पीड ऑफ 90 किलोमीटर पर आवर यानी कि इनिशियली ट्रेन की जो स्पीड है वो पहले से ही 90 किलोमीटर पर आवर दी हुई है सो वी विल राइट यू Initial speed is 90 km per hour. Okay? Whenever speed is given in km per hour, then we will convert this into meter per second. How we will convert it? So we will see that how km per hour has to be converted into meter per second. To convert km per hour into meter per second, we multiply the quantity with 5/18. Okay? So we will write 19 multiply 5/18 and now it will become meter per second. Okay, meter per second. 18 say ye 5 times. So you will be 25 meter per second now. Okay, next is train is moving with this speed. Brakes are applied. Whenever brakes are applied, then acceleration will decrease, acceleration will be negative. It means speed will decrease or we may say velocity will decrease with time. Now brakes are applied and acceleration is given. A is equals to minus 0.5 meter per second square. Okay. Find how far the train will go before it draws to rest. Whenever the brakes are applied, then finally train will After just decreasing its velocity, finally train will stop. Okay? Train or any vehicle, whenever brakes are applied, then it will finally stop. And it is given. Before coming to rest, how much distance is it will cover? So, whenever when it is going to be rest, so we will take final velocity equals to 0. And distance is asked. Okay? So, we will put question mark over distance. As time is not given, in these all information, so we will use third equation of motion. So we will write as time is not given, we have by third equation of motion. Okay, what we have from third equation of motion? V square is equals to u square plus 2as. Putting values from above. What we will get? V is final velocity, which is 0. U is initial velocity, which is 25. It means 25 ka square plus 2 into A ki value kitni hai? 0.5 meter per second into S is we have to find. We have to find distance. So this is. Okay. Or it will be 0 equals to 25 ka square 625. Okay. Plus 2 into 0.5. Ye minus ka tha. Okay. Jab ye value minus ki thi, to yahan pe ye माइनस प्लस माइनस हो जाएगा, तो 2 इंटू 0.5 इंटू एस। इस पूरी वैल्यू को लेफ्ट साइड में हम ले आएंगे तो ये माइनस की वैल्यू प्लस हो जाएगी, इट मीन्स इट विल बी 2 इंटू 0.5 मल्टीप्लाई एस इक्वल्स टू 625। ओके, नाउ ये जो दोनों वैल्यूज है 2 इंटू 01, इनको अपॉन में ले जाइए, डिस्टेंस कैलकुलेट हो जाएगी। हाउ वी विल डू दिस, ओके, इट विल बी एस इक्वल्स टू 625 अपॉन 2 इंटू 0.5। 2 इंटू 0.5 कितना होता है, 1 होता है, ओके, बिकॉज दिस इज हाफ, सो इट विल बी 625 अपॉन 1 और s is equals to 625 meters, okay? So the train when brakes are applied before coming to rest will cover this much distance. We will write, so the train will cover 625 meter distance before coming to rest. Okay, this will be answer of question number 2. Now come to, just jump to question number 3. Okay, question number 3. What is given in question number 3? Just let's see. Question number 3 has a trolley while going down an inclined plane. Okay, now what is inclined plane? First of all, we will look into what is inclined plane. Inclined plane is like this. Okay. Inclined plane is the plane which makes some angle with the horizontal. This is horizontal direction. Okay, horizontal direction से जो plane कोई angle बनाए, that is called inclined plane. तो एक trolley है जो inclined plane पर move कर रही है. It is something like this. Okay, let's say this is trolley. Okay, ये हमने trolley बना ली और ये trolley जो है इस तरीके से जा रही है. ठीक है, something like this. Okay, when trolley starts to move, then definitely it will start from rest. Okay, it will start from rest. So from this question information we may write u is equals to 0 at, as it is given, a trolley while going down an inclined plane has an acceleration. So acceleration is given, acceleration is 2 centimeter per second square. Okay, centimeter per second square. So we have to convert this centimeter into meter per second square. So we will do what? In 1 centimeter, how many meters are there? In 1 centimeter, 1 upon 100 meters are there. So we will convert this centimeter into meters by dividing 100. Then it will be meter per second square. This will be the acceleration. And how we have taken u equals to 0? Because it will start to move from rest. Okay, now what? 2 centimeter. What will be its velocity 3 seconds after the start? Okay, so time is given 3 seconds. Okay, and it is asked its final velocity. Final velocity is asked. So we will do what? Let's see. It is v velocity. Now its final velocity is r. So acceleration is given, initial speed is given, time is given. We will use first equation of motion. By first equation of motion, first equation of motion is v equals to u plus at. Okay, or v is equals to u, initial velocity is 0 plus acceleration is 2 upon 100 and time is 3 seconds. Okay, so it will be v is equals to 2 3 6 upon 100. So it will be come out to be 0.06 meter per second. Okay, this will be the final speed that trolley will gain. So we will write the trolley on inclined plane. Trolley on inclined plane will get the speed 0.06 meter per second finally. okay? This is the answer. This is how you have to solve the question. Moreover, एक important बात बहुत यहाँ पर ये आती है कि हमें ये वाली ये कैसे पता चलता है कि first equation of motion ही use करेंगे. देखिए first equation of motion उस केस में use होती है जब distance ना दी जाए और ना पूछी जाए. Okay? तो इसमें distance ना दे रखी है कहीं पे और ना ही हमसे पूछी गई है. Moreover, time is given. Okay? Whenever time is given, then we will use first equation of motion and distance is not asked. This is how we will estimate that why we use equation number 1. Okay, now we move forward. This is equation, question number 3rd is over now. And now we are erasing it. And I hope that inclined plane, concept of inclined plane is clear from here. Okay, now come to question number 4. Let's see what is given in question number 4. Okay, in question number 4 it is given. What is given in question number 4? A racing car has a uniform acceleration of 4 meter per second. So, uniform acceleration is given 4 meter per second square. Now, what distance will it cover in 10 seconds after start? Okay, so when it will start, then it will start from rest. So initial velocity will be 0. Okay, and it has been asked after start time 10 seconds. 10 seconds after, how much distance it will cover. Now the point to be noted here, distance is asked. So we may use second equation of motion and along with time. Whenever time and distance is asked, time is given and distance is asked, then we may use equation number 2. And time is not given and distance is asked, then we may use equation number 3. Because in equation number 3, time is not mentioned, time is not there. Okay? So, we will use here distance is asked. So, by second equation of motion. Second equation of motion. Okay, second equation of motion is s equals to ut plus 1 by 2 at square. Now, putting the value, we will get s is equals to, as it is starting from rest, 0 multiply 10 plus 1 by 2, a is 4 meter per second square and t time is 10 seconds ka square. 2 se ye 4, 2 times, s is equals to, it will be 2 multiply 10 ka square kitna ho jayega 100, it will be 200 meters. Okay, so the racing car will cover 200 meter in 10 seconds. We will write, so the racing car will cover a distance of 200 meter distance of 200 meters after 10 seconds from its start. Okay, from its start. This is how we will solve question number 4. Okay, now before coming to question number 5, there are some important things that we must know. Okay, let's see what these are. Before question number 5, I am just telling you something. What are the equations of motion whenever any object is falling? Okay, now we will see. Here we have finished question number 5. If any object is falling, okay, if any object is falling, then क्या होता है जो फर्स्ट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन होती है या तीनों इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन होती है उसमें हम क्या करते हैं जो एक्सेलरेशन है उसको जी से रिप्लेस कर देते हैं. देन वी रिप्लेस ओके एक्सेलरेशन ए बाय जी. जी क्या है? ये जी है एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. स्मॉल जी इज एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी. ओके, एंड इट्स वैल्यू यूज टू बी 9.8 मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. अब यहाँ पे बेटा ये इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है. इम्पोर्टेंट बात क्या है, आपको ये याद रखना है कि जब कभी भी ये जो जी होता है 9.8 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर अगर आपको क्वेश्चन में दिया जाए तो वो वैल्यू यूज करनी है। क्वेश्चन में कई बार ये 9.8 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर भी दिया हो सकता है और 10 भी दिया हो सकता है, और ये वर्ड जरूरी नहीं है कि एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी ही करके आपको यूज करें। ये आपको सिंपली कह सकता है कि जब कोई ऑब्जेक्ट ऊपर से नीचे गिर रहा है तो उसका एक्सेलरेशन 10 मीटर पर सेकंड स्क्वायर है, देन वी हैव टू यूज दिस, इस वैल्यू को इस तरीके से यूज करना है। एंड उस केस में डिस्टेंस को हाइट लिख देते हैं हम, डिस्टेंस क्या हो जाती है, हाइट हो जाती है। देन जो तीनों इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन है जैसे कि v इक्वल्स टू यू प्लस एटी है तो वो इक्वेशन हो जाएगी हमारी कन्वर्ट टू दिस इक्वेशन विल कन्वर्टेड इनटू v इक्वल्स टू यू प्लस जी टी। ओके, जी क्यों लगा दिया, क्योंकि अब यहाँ पे गिरने के लिए जब कोई ऑब्जेक्ट फॉल करेगी तो जी एक्सेलरेशन उसमें होता है। दूसरी इक्वेशन s इक्वल्स टू यू टी प्लस हाफ एटी स्क्वायर होता है, ये इक्वेशन हो जाएगी s की जगह पे h आ जाता है, हाइट आ जाता है, एंड यू टी प्लस a की जगह पे क्या आ जाएगा हमारा g आ जाएगा, देन इट विल बी h इक्वल्स टू यू टी प्लस हाफ जी टी स्क्वायर। एंड थर्ड इक्वेशन क्या हो जाएगी, v स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू यू स्क्वायर प्लस टू ए एस, ये थर्ड इक्वेशन हो जाती है हमारी, v स्क्वायर इक्वल्स टू यू स्क्वायर प्लस टू जी एच। This is how the equation of motion will be used whenever any object is falling downward. Okay? You have to remember. और अगर कोई ऑब्जेक्ट को नीचे से ऊपर फेंका जाए, मान लीजिए कोई ऑब्जेक्ट नीचे से ऊपर फेंकी जाए, तब ये जो g होता है, ये जो acceleration की value होती है g, ये minus ली जाएगी। तो यहाँ पे हम लिख रहे हैं when any object is thrown upward, when any object is thrown upwards, okay? Then a is equals to कितना हो जाएगा, minus g. So क्या हो जाएंगी equation of motion? पहली equation हो जाएगी v equals to u minus gt. दूसरी हो जाएगी h equals to ut minus half gt square, and third equation will be v square is equals to u square minus 2gh. ये तीनों equation हमको use करनी है जब कोई object नीचे से ऊपर फेंका जाए, like this, okay? ऐसे करके कोई object ऊपर की तरफ फेंका गया और इसने height h cover करी, okay? Like this, ये ground से फेंका गया ऐसे करके, और इस वाले केस में क्या था, कोई ऑब्जेक्ट ऊपर से नीचे आ रही है लाइक दिस, ओके, ग्राउंड की तरफ आ रही है, ठीक है। इस चीज को आपने ध्यान रखना है। मोर ओवर एक चीज और ध्यान रखनी है आपको, जब कभी भी ऑब्जेक्ट नीचे से ऊपर फेंका जाता है तो इसकी वेलोसिटी